So my title of my talk is Nonlinear Supersymmetric General Relativity Theory and the Unity of Nature. The second and the part one I will present in the International Conference of celebrating Professor Yan's 85th birthday about several years ago. This is the second part. The content of my talk is I want to discuss many problems. Therefore, I only discuss the basic ideas and some new results. We add for this conference the Suzy Yamiz theory is included in this talk. So now, the motivation of my talk is this one. We have two standard generality and the Georgia Weinberg-Salam model. How to unify these two standard models? However, these succeeded model has many so unpleasant or unsolved fundamental problems. I want to discuss all these problems in myself. Okay. And also, for example, general relativity, as the Einstein general relativity is defined on physical space time. Okay. And the geometrical discussion on physical space time is essential. However, supergravity is formulated on the mathematical space. X mu is this one. However, theta alpha is there. Mathematical also, Julius or Professor Best said also. Mathematical, superspecific mathematical. Therefore, I want to try to discuss a new Suzy theorem on physical spaces, on specific physical space time. And I found that the three generation is included in SO10 superpoint current symmetry because SOM symmetry is very natural for super. Poincaré group, therefore, n equal 8, maximally existing n equal 8 was investigated by Gell-Mann, but it was too small. Therefore, I extend to n equal 10. 10 supercharge, we divide 5 plus 5 star. 5, we assign 5 to 5, they are exactly the same counter numbers of SU5 GAT to this 5. The fundamental SO10 has 10 spinner charge, but 5 is SU5. 5 star. 5 has exactly the same quantum number of SU5 GAT. And by using this assignment, I can construct the full helicity tower state of the SO10 super Poincaré. This is the result. This is graviton here, singlet, spin 3 half 1. This is adjoint 2045. And this is the spin 1/2, including three supercharges here. This is two subadjoint, and so on, up to spin 3, helicity 3. So there are so many helicities. However, here we assume the preliminary super Higgs mechanism means that the higher massless state eat lower helicity states as a longitudinal component in standard mode invariant way. Then this is a survival. Here, there are exactly three generations of quarks, leptons, and also quarks and other some exotics here. These states are the survivors of SO10 super Poincaré in the low energy limit, I think. Okay? Then, now I want to construct the such n equal 10 supersymmetric theory, including gravity, but everybody knows there is no Gauss theorem when n beyond n equal 8. This is the argument from S matrix. Therefore, how to circumvent the no Gauss theorem? I think to taking the degenerate space time is essential to circumvent the no Gauss theorem. Okay? Therefore, what is the degenerate space time? It is very easy. For example, we take degenerate vector. And it is given by nonlinear representation of the supersymmetry. Okay? Then, I explained just this brief review of Volkov-Akhlov, the inventor of the nonlinear representation. Okay? Take a flat space, x mu and omega, sorry, this is Grassmannian, and consider one home, and from one home is invariant this transformation, and invariant action is given by volume of four-dimensional space-time constructed by one form. Then this is the nonlinear representation of supersymmetry, very simple, and also completely geometric. Now, I want to incorporate this nonlinear representation on Riemann space-time. Okay? So then, my Riemann space-time, this is peculiar because the tangent space of new space-time is specified by Esterházy-Grassmann coordinate, psi alpha, or nonlinear Suji, besides the ordinary SO13 Minkowski coordinate XA. Yeah, this is the tangent space of my space, Riemann space. Now, the question is that what is the unified Fierbaum of this funny Riemann space? I found that, this is a picture of our basic assumption. This is ordinary curve space. Tangent space is specified and Grassmann. What is the unified Fierbaum? This I find that unified Fierbaum is given by this. Okay? WA is the superposition of Einstein-Fierbaum plus TMU. TMU is the mimic Fierbaum, come from the nonlinear representation. But this is enough, and so on. Now, what? Now it is clear that this is the fundamental axiom in my theory, n equal n extended nonlinear Suji general relativity action. Oh, my. Most
the function of x and psi.
Yes. Yes. Now, at the moment, we calculated by using the unified Fierbaum W. This is the empty space. Okay. And I skipped this one. This is a very formal argument. Now. And here, nonlinear Suji has the dimensional constant. However, now dimensional constant is fixed to lambda over g. Lambda is the cosmological term, g is the Newtonian constant. Now, nonlinear Suji, dimensional constant is presented this way. And also, now this model predicts the space-time dimension 4, because in this theory, the isomorphism of SO1, D-1, and SLDC is, this isomorphism is important. Now, in this isomorphism holds only for D equal 4, four-dimensional Minkowski space. Okay, therefore, this formalism holds only in four dimensions. Now, so invariance. Yeah, data comes from the exact form. Okay? Now, this is a space-time invariance. There are enough. Also, internal symmetry is here. And I show you some very interesting, for example, this is a nonlinear Suji transformation invariance. Okay, this is ordinary nonlinear transformation, but Fierbaum is transformed in this way under this one. Under these transformations, unified Fierbaum is transformed in this way. This is exactly the GL4R transformation of Fierbaum. Therefore, and the commutator is given also GL4R. Therefore, we are closed. Okay, and also Lorentz invariance is also interesting, but I skipped them. Yeah. Oh, no. This is the Lorentz. Oh. Pardon?
Is that symmetry
globally? Yeah, it's global Suji. Global symmetry. Yes. Pardon?
We have n copies of it.
N up to the 10. We can. Now, my point is that this is a non-trivial solution, n larger than 10, or larger than 8, including gravity. Okay? And so, there is a supercurrent, and all supercurrent is written in this way, and so the vacuum decay to fear by, and this is Nabokov-Gorson problem. We call Sparrow, he's here, spin 1/2, not Newtonian, this is Nabokov-Gorson. Then the vacuum decay to the through supercurrent fear by and Nabokov-Gorson phenomenon. This is the coupling constant to the vacuum. Okay, we call this is a big decay. Therefore, the specific Riemann spacetime automatically induce big decay to Riemann's Einstein gravity and also Nabokov-Gorson phenomenon Sparrow is here. Okay. And now, this is the exact form of in detail. I start from the nonlinear surge general relativity action, but this action decays to the Sparrow graviton action, return Einstein Riemann scalar Riemann is here, and also this is matter interaction, and also this is the Sparrow graviton model after big decay. So now, what is the next question? What is the true vacuum of this very complicated action? I show that the true vacuum of this action is achieved when ordinary familiar linear Suzy theory emerges from the vacuum. This is the sketch of the picture. This is the starting picture. I have no time. Now I show you the SGM very complicated Fermi action is equivalent to the linear Suzy action, which is very popular nowadays. Okay, for example, now we consider n equal to 2. N equal to 2 case, okay? We consider here nonlinear Suzy n equal to 2 nonlinear Suzy action, and for simplicity, now I consider vacuum we consider in flat space, okay? Flat space is a nonlinear Suzy action written in psi. We flat space hereby go to 1. Yeah. So now what is the this is the n equal to Polk-Harkov action. This is flat space of n equal NL Suzy ZR. Okay, this action is equivalent to n equal to linear Suzy QED action. This is the very popular n equal to Suzy QED. This is gauge multiplate, this is matter multiplate, and the action is this is the action of n equal to Suzy QED. They are equivalent because, to show that they are, I have no time. For example, the vector is represented in this way. So this is gauge multiplate, linear Suzy gauge multiplate vector. So-called this is 14, like people say, but n equal to is not 14. Yeah, yes. And also scalar auxiliary field. And also for matter multiplate, they are expressed in this. This is the expression also. Or linear multiplate is represented in terms of Nabokov-Gorson fermion Sparrow Hill. And so now, substituting these expression into this action, this linear Suzy action, becomes to this action. I skip the detail, anyway, this is a straightforward calculation. Therefore, this action is equivalent to this action. Okay. Now, what is the true vacuum of this one? I look for the true vacuum of this action. of this action. Now, I show you, I have no time to discuss details, now I show the result. This is the result. This part is the systematics of to find the compositeness equation, composite relation, but I skip the no time. So, okay, this is the potential of the linear SUSE, equivalent linear SUSE, and by what? Expanding the field around the true vacuum, we obtain two isomorphic vacuum, but one is very interesting. So this is the interesting one. Yeah. So two scalar field, one scalar field, and one two Fortean-like massive. This is mass, and another two scalars and another two spin massive here, but. Oh, different. Their mass is different, but and also two massless photon, massless photon sphere. The photon is this is the number of Higgs mode, which will be absorbed to the non-abelian degree. But anyway, this is the U1. SU2 is n equal to the U1 model. Therefore, still. Okay. So now we have very interesting result. Now the our n equal to has. Describe one massive charged Dirac fermion, one massive neutral Dirac fermion, one massless vector photon, and one charged scalar, one neutral compu scalar. These are exactly the lepton sector of standard model. Okay? And of course, at this stage, SU2 is still global. Now, so this is the summary up to here. In Riemann flat space-time SGM, SGM is a Sparrow graviton model after big decay. Ordinary linear SUSE gauge theory with spontaneous SUSE breaking emerges as a massless composite of Nam-Goldstone fermion from the nonlinear SUSE cosmological term of SGM or NL SUSE GR or cosmological term of Fanny. Specific space-time. Okay. Now, cosmological meaning of this model. Now, so the dark energy density of the universe is we know dark energy, the magnitude of four-dimensional dark energy density of the universe equal almost the mass of neutron. Okay. In this model, but this is very natural because the dimensional constant comes from the SUSE breaking scale, which comes from the back cosmological term of nonlinear SUSE, nonlinear general theory. Therefore, this is very natural. Four dimensional dark energy density of the universe, which is the cosmological term of specific, peculiar, funny space time, but this term go to the Majorana mass of the Majorana spinner and then the neutron mass. Now we go to the summary. Yeah, nonlinear SUSE general relativity scenario. We need only the four dimensional space time, which is specified by ordinary Minkowski and plus Grassmann, yeah, on the ordinary curved space time. And upon this space-time, and also with positive, lambda positive cosmological, the Mach principle is encoded geometrically means that Grassmannian and Minkowski coded are treated equal footing on the standard starting point. After big decay of the fundamental action, go to the Sparrow graviton highly non-linear Nam-Goldstone action, but this Nam-Goldstone action is equivalent to linear SUSE action. This means that the cosmological constant of starting tiny space-time is the origin of everything. Okay? And predictions and conjectures, many predictions, no predictions, conjectures, speculations, wishful conjectures, and so on. So anyway. Now, group theory, SO10 is interesting. 10 is divided by five star. Then we know five fundamental fermionic constituents. These constituents have exactly the same quantum numbers SU5 got. And in this model, after the very wishful super Higgs mechanism among the survivors of the helicity state, spin 3 half lepton type doublet, may survive. And also doubly charged spin 1 half particle. And also, we found that there is only one Higgs state. There are many so helicity, but in the surviving scalar state, there are only one Higgs. One Higgs means only one standard model Higgs state survive in this scenario. I think this may be very suggestive. And also, chiral symmetry is also predicted in this model. I skip this because the exact solution of nonlinear Suzy Volkov approximation I survey. But free solution exists only Nambu-Goldstone fermion is chiral eigenstate. If Nambu-Goldstone fermion is not chiral state, there are no free equation. This comes from the higher order self-interaction. Higher order self-interaction of Nambu-Goldstone fermion control the helicity of the Nambu-Goldstone fermion. Okay? And also, I'm tired. So, many open questions, and I have not looked at them anyway. Oh, yeah, they are an interesting point. Yeah. Probably most of you don't know. Physical spin three half nonlinear representation of supersymmetry exists. It was written by Bacrini. He was when he was interested by Salam. He wrote this paper, and I found this paper and. But this is very important because in my theory, there is a helicity state spin 5 half. But when 5 half state become massive, we need massive spin 3 half, Goldstone fermion. It's here. Therefore, I think there is no basic difficulty in this scenario. And when I wrote this paper referring to their Bacrini sent me an email. Thank you very much for your for your citation. My very old, but he was very satisfied with this final found. So that's all.
Yeah, any questions?